everybody got problems. Yeah, but waiting on my way to solve them. I really came up from the bottom. Struggling my mama on the last dollar.
Hey, what's up, guys? Today we're gonna do brake pad install on my 95 EG Civic Hatch. So I have some Hawk brake pads. This right here, HP Plus is what they're called. I got them for a pretty good price off Tire Rack. It was like $75. These are recommended for street and track use. So we're doing rotors front and rear with all four brake pads on this. This one is a 95 EG, but previous owner converted it to a SI brake caliper and rotor for the front only. The rear is disconverted also. Some of you guys might have drum brakes still. But the main difference about the front here is that since these are SI slash EX Civic rotors, these are 10.5 inch diameter rotors, so they're a little bit bigger than the regular DX-DX. And these are also bigger calipers, but what you want to pay attention to is that the SI and the EX, they have bigger calipers, but the difference is that there is ABS on one of them. So if you have ABS calipers, the brake pads are different. And then I have the, let me show you guys. I have the ABS caliper. The car doesn't have ABS, but the caliper is ABS. And you can tell by the brake pads here that it mounts up from kind of like in the middle and the bottom, but you'll be able to tell once you take yours off. That's the main difference right there. These are ABS calipers, okay, for SI and EX rotors and calipers. So the brake pads are different. Make sure you check those. So today we'll be doing the brake pads. This is the tools that you guys are going to be using right here. Very basic tools. You'll have a C-clamp here, or you can use a brake pad spreader. It's up to you. Have a 12 millimeter, 14 millimeter, and 17 millimeter wrench. And also you want to get the sockets too. This is a 10 millimeter. This is for the brake bleeder on the caliper. So take those. Ratchet. This is needle nose pliers for the rear. They actually spin on. I'll show you guys in the rear in a second, but the piston actually spins back in instead of pressing with a clamp. So you can use this tool right here. I don't really like using this tool, it kind of sucks, but I'd rather just use needle nose. That tool comes in handy if the caliper is really hard to compress in. And also your brake cleaner and brake grease. But let me show you guys over here that, let's see. You can tell by the slots on the piston. I don't know if you guys can see it, but see those slots on the piston? They actually twist in clockwise to go in rather than just compress in with a C-clamp or brake spreader. So make sure you have that tool if you have rear disc brakes. All right, so we'll go ahead and start off with the front brake pad install. Show you guys how to take them off first. So this is the front. I'm gonna show you guys from the back. All right, so you see two brackets or two bolts on the rear bracket. It's gonna be top up here, bottom down there. It's gonna be a 17 millimeter. Go ahead and break those loose. And then you also have on the caliper itself, it's gonna be two, I don't know what size these are. Here, let me check. So I have two wrenches on here just to show you guys for reference. It's gonna be a 17 millimeter on the bracket bolts right here, 17-1. Up there is another one, 17. Go ahead and break those loose, and then you break loose the bottom one right here. It's gonna be a 12 millimeter, top right there, or bottom right there, and then top up there by the brake line. So go ahead and remove those. Once you remove that, you can basically take off this whole caliper and your rotor will come out. All right, so we're on the other side now for the install. Go ahead and get your brake rotor. You put it right there. Right inside. The front didn't have these bolts that they usually come with for to hold the rotor in place. You don't really need them, but sometimes you might have them installed on yours already. You might need like the little impact screwdriver to take them out. But once you have those on, put those two right there. But I'm gonna leave mine off since it didn't come with it. And then you go ahead and get your brake caliper here and install your 17 millimeter bolts onto the knuckle. So here I'm putting on the brake bracket bolt onto the knuckle right there. It just slides right back there. It's two bolts, 17s. Hand tighten them for now as much as you can. There
All right, that should be good. And go ahead, and since you should have already broken off these 12 millimeter for the caliper itself, it makes it a lot easier to slide it out. So you don't have to try to break it when the caliper is out. So you get more leverage once they're bolted in. So just make sure you break them before you unbolt the bracket itself. Let me get these off for you guys.
I'll tell you guys, since the caliper is back on with the two 12 millimeter bolts, make sure you break loose this brake bleeder right here. It's a 10 millimeter bolt. Let's go ahead and break it and then tighten it back up hand tight, all right?
All right, guys, so once you guys have the caliper out, that's how it should look like right there. The caliper is hanging. Make sure you have it hanging in a secure place. If not, use like bungee cords or something, hang it up to the control arm so that it doesn't pinch the brake line. So once you have this caliper bracket right here, go ahead and lubricate your brake pads. So you just need them on the side where it mounts up into the bracket, basically. I have this brake grease right here that Hawk provided. It's whatever. I actually prefer the gel type that you can buy at your auto parts store right here. It comes with a brush, so it's a lot easier, but I already used them on the other side, so I might as well just use them. So right there, show you guys. Right where it mounts up into the bracket, lubricate it so it doesn't squeak. Also for the rear, or not the rear, on the other side, lubricate them. Make sure you don't get any on the actual brake pad itself, okay? So on one of the sides, it has this bracket right here. Let me see. It has this bracket. I like to hang it basically on the back end, just so it doesn't show in the front. It doesn't really matter, but go ahead and install that for you guys real quick. Okay, so the back side brake pad's on right now. I'll go ahead and show you guys how to do it in the front. So I get the bottom on first. It'll snap in place. Let me show you. That's kind of hard to do it with one hand. There you go. See how it snaps in place in the bottom? Then you could just slide the front right there, push it in. And there you go. So brake pads are in the bracket right now. Now, what we need to do next is compress that piston right there. So I'll show you how to do that right now.
All right, so I have this set up for you guys. This right here is your C-clamp. I went ahead and I put a brake, my old brake pad actually, between the C-clamp and the piston. Go ahead and break your brake bleeder loose just a little bit. It's the proper way to do it. I mean, you guys don't have to break, I'm gonna close that. You guys don't have to break the brake bleeder open, but it's proper to do it just in case, because the fluids will travel back through your seals and usually up your master cylinder. So it's usually better just to open it up and flush it out anyways. But like I said, you guys don't have to, because if you do it this method, you are gonna have to bleed the brakes afterwards, okay? So I'll go ahead and show you guys. See it dripping right there. Make sure you have a rag underneath or something to catch it. And you just go ahead and spin it clockwise, okay? So as you spin it clockwise, you can see the piston moving in right now. It's kind of hard to do it with one hand. Alright, that should be good enough. Let me see. Give me a second. This GoPro can't see anything. Okay, so once that's good, go ahead and take off your C-clamp. Take off the old brake pad. I usually like to use the brake pad just in between so you don't damage your piston, your brake piston. And then go ahead and lubricate your brake piston with brake grease, okay? So go ahead and do that. It's much easier when you have a brush. So this will help lubricate it and prevent it from rusting out and stuff like that. Put that back in and then go ahead and install your caliper back onto the bracket. All right, so this is how it's gonna look like. Back piston goes on the back of the brake pad, forward like that. Let me try to get it. Get this in, give me a second. All right, so this is how the caliper will look. It goes through these things right here. Oh yeah, and there's also these smooth slots on it. Let me take this out and show you guys. All right, so once you put the brake caliper in, it should look something like this. I have this nut that goes right here. Basically, it goes in like that. Usually take this off and lubricate it first, okay? So
go ahead and do that real quick. So you don't have to go too crazy on it. Just a little something like that. So these have slots on them. You see that there's a flat side. So there's actually, the flat side will go where it mounts up to the caliper. So make sure you put it in that way too. So put this back in. There's one on the bottom side too. I'm just showing you guys the top. So when your caliper slides in, it mounts up from the flat side with the bottom. All right, so make sure the bottom and the top is like that. See right now in the bottom, it's not aligned. So that's why your caliper might not fit. There we go. So now it's lined up front and top with the slots. And then you go ahead and put your bolts through 12 millimeter. Just feed them through right there and tighten them up. All right, so right now I'm just tightening up the 12 millimeter bolts for the caliper and just tighten those up until they stop. But don't do it all the way tight first, because remember you have to tighten up your 17 millimeter bracket bolts first. That way the caliper is secure, and then you can go ahead and tighten these up, all right? All right, so right now I'm just tightening up the bracket bolts. I'm sure you guys are on it. Tightening up the bracket bolts right here. Make sure those are tight. That should be, that's good right there. So remember bottom and the top, okay? Once those are tightened up, you can finally tighten up these caliper bolts right here, 12 millimeter. And don't forget, these are hand tight right now, okay? I leave them hand tight because I'm gonna bleed the brace later. This two-person job, by the way, so if you don't have anybody help you, you can leave it in, but I like to take them out just to basically flush out the brakes. All right, guys, so this is how it should look when everything's mounted up. 17 millimeters, both top and bottom are tightened up. These 12 millimeters are tightened up also. The brake bleeder right there, it's still hand tight right now. Like I said, I'm gonna bleed the brakes. Don't forget to bleed the brakes if you do it this way, because the car will not have brakes if you don't bleed them, all right? So you're gonna go inside the car, brake pedal's gonna go straight down if you don't do this. So make sure you don't forget, all right? So hand tight right now, just because we're gonna get back to it. Yeah, that's how it should look. Get some brake cleaner right here. Go ahead and just spray it. Skip whatever residue off. It's always nice to have brake cleaner, right? So I'll go ahead and move to the rear brakes now. All right, let's go ahead and move to the rear of the vehicle now. This is the rear setup. This one's a little harder than the front, just by a little bit. Same stuff, same concept though. Just because it has this caliper, e-brake caliper setup. So go ahead and make sure your e-brake is down for this step, okay? So make sure your e-brake's down. Go ahead and brake loose. Let me get under here. So go ahead and brake loose the bracket bolts, top and bottom. This is a 14 millimeter for the back, okay? Hope you guys can see that, but 14 millimeter. And then the caliper itself is a 12 millimeter. And then you have your brake bleeder right there is 10 millimeters, okay? So break this open, hand tie them back up so it doesn't drip fluid, and go ahead and do that step. So this is on the other side. I already had it off. The caliper or the rotor should have these bolts. This one it's kind of a weird bolt, but this is for the brake rotor bolt that I showed you guys earlier that holds it onto place. So take that, the rotor off, and the caliper basically sits like this. You have the caliper right here, or this is the caliper, and you have the bracket separate. I'll show you guys how to install now. All right, got your rotor here. Go ahead and put your rotor back on, just like that. And then get your rotor bolt. Where's the bolt at? Damn, I lost it. Let me find it. All right, I found it. So I only have one on each side, which you'll be fine with. Let me get this on for you guys. All right, so for the rotor, basically tighten it up with a Phillips screwdriver right there. Usually there's two of them, I only have one, so just tighten that up. All right, so this is what your bracket should look like. Basically, it'll go on that way. So these are the bracket bolts, and then these are the caliper bolts in the back with the boot. Make sure you lubricate the caliper bolts right here for brake grease, and then go ahead and put them back on right through the bracket, all right? All right, so I went ahead and lubricated the bolts. You can see it right there. Just
So it's back on, and go ahead and install it back onto the knuckle right now with the 17 millimeter bolts going this way, okay?
So that's how the bracket looks. I don't know if you guys can see that, but here's the bracket right here. The bolts go back here, one up there. Yep, right there, 14 millimeter. Hand tie it first, and then tighten it down with a ratchet or a wrench, 14 millimeter. Bracket goes through the rotor right there, so that's how it should sit, okay? So bolt goes through the knuckle, and then it'll go through the bracket. So, show you guys there. Just hand tighten it first, and I'm gonna go ahead and tighten them down right now. So, top one, I'm tightening it right now. Bottom one, make sure it's tight. Top. Got like no leverage with one hand. All right, should be good. All right, so now you're gonna go ahead and move on to the caliper here. So the caliper brake bleeder right here has a boot. Let me take that one off. All right, so brake bleeder is hand loose on this one right here. I'm gonna tighten it back up, hand tighten it. And we'll go ahead and lubricate our brake pads now. All right, so here's your brake pad right here. Remember, don't get any brake grease on the pad itself, just on where it goes onto the caliper, okay? So I don't think I can do that with one hand, but just don't put too much, just a good amount, just so it covers it. I don't know if you guys can see, but there's that right there. Flip it around, and then lubricate that side right there. Wish I had more hands right now. All right, so finished product should look like that. Lubricated on the side, the top, all right, top and bottom. Then just go ahead and slide it right in to your bracket. Just like that. All right, got the back side on. And Leo's here. What's up, Leo? Wanna help me record for you?
Let's do it,
dude. And I'm about to finish up right now though. All right, so basically it'll look like that. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and compress the piston right here. See the slots? I'm gonna go ahead and use a needle nose plier. Not use that brake tool I showed you earlier. Go ahead and crack open your brake bleeder a little bit and have Leo record from here. All right, so you get the needle nose pliers in the slots. Oh shit. Get them in the slots and then you turn it clockwise for it to go in, all right? So. Get it in closer. So. All right, so basically once it sits flush, you'll be able to fit the new brake pads in. So let's go ahead and try it out. Close the bleeder, hand tight. And you just fit the behind the brake pads in the back and bring it over up front. And basically just like that. Make sure you get the slots right there, how it sits flush, just like in the front, so that it lines up with the caliper. So you guys see that. So, and then 12 millimeter bolts, you'll be able to get it in. All right, so this was the brake tool that I was talking about earlier. It goes onto a ratchet. You see there's slots on the holes for the piston. So basically when you turn it, it'll turn the piston. I don't like using it because of the angle that you get it in. It's kind of hard to keep it still. So that's why I use needle nose instead. It's a lot faster. But if you guys had to, you'd use that. Go ahead and use your 12 millimeter bolts and put it into the caliper in place. Hand tighten first, and then go ahead and use the 12 millimeter and tighten it up. Alright, so 12 millimeter, tighten it up first. And top one. Alright, those are flush. Tighten it up with a wrench till it stops, then quarter turn. Same thing with the top. You feel it stop and do quarter turn. Alright, so then you should have your 14 millimeter bracket tightened up. You have your two 12 millimeters tightened up, and you have your brake bleeder hand tight because they still need to be bled right now. Once you're done with that, just go ahead and hit it with some brake cleaner, just like the front. Brake cleaner, and just spray it all around. get all that greased off. And then don't forget, tighten up that Phillips bolt right there for the rotor and you're good.
All right, guys, so for this car, I'm doing dot four brake fluids. It's better for high temps since I'm gonna be tracking this thing. So basically, I'm gonna flush it out first. If you guys are just doing regular dot three, what most cars do, make sure to keep this master cylinder right here topped off. It's usually on the driver's side. For most cars in America, it's gonna be driver's side anyways. So you wanna go ahead and you start with the brake caliper in the rear, farthest from the master cylinder. So that's gonna be rear passenger side. So basically, one person will be back here, have a wrench. I don't know where my wrench is, but have a wrench on this brake bleeder. So all the brake bleeders are closed right now, okay? So make sure they're all closed. So you're gonna have someone pump, and then basically someone's gonna release it while the person inside holds it down, okay? So I'll show you guys how to do it right now. All right, Leo. So we got Leo up in here. He's gonna push on the brake pedal right now. Go ahead. So it's gonna go all the way down very soft at first because all the brake pistons are basically spread out since we compressed it. So just keep on pumping it. Go like, let's go 15 times. So you wanna go in like a pretty, like a normal, just down, up. You don't wanna do it too fast because then you'll create air bubbles inside the brake fluid. So just go ahead all the way down, up, all the way down and up. Sometimes the first time you compress it,
it's getting tough.
It's getting a little hard?
Yeah.
Just keep going. So that's how you want it to be hard right there. So basically when I tell you to hold, you're gonna hold it all the way down as much as you can. Mm-hmm. So when I open it, it's gonna go down a little more. So keep it down there, right? All right. So go ahead and pump it about five more times. I'm gonna tell you to hold it, okay? All right, so right now Leo's holding down on the brake pads or brake pedal. I'm gonna break this open right here. And you might want to have like a oil pan or something because it's going to spray fluid down. So watch, I'll go ahead and pop it. See, fluid comes out. It's, the brake pedal went all the way down, right?
Yep.
All right, hold on. Then I go ahead and tighten it up. Now tell him to pump again. Go ahead and pump. So do it about 10 to 15 times, okay? All right. So basically you do this on all the brake calipers. So you start from the rear, farthest from master side. So that's rear passenger. You hop onto the rear driver's side, then do same thing with the front, farthest from the master cylinder. So you're gonna do passenger side caliper, and then you're gonna hop into the driver's side caliper. So do all four until your brake pedal feels really firm, all right? All right, so when you guys are doing this, make sure you have like a rag or an oil pan on there, and then make sure there's always brake fluid in the master cylinder, all right? So I'll go ahead and top mine off. I know it's low right now. So make sure you don't get any brake fluid on your paint either because it will melt your paint, all right? So let's find a way to pour this. So this is dot four brake fluid. It is compatible with dot three, so you can mix it, but I'm trying to get as much dot four in here as possible. It's better for boiling temperatures for the track and stuff. So that's topped off. And we'll go ahead and go back into bleeding it. Alright, so you see the fluid comes out. I'll tighten it back up. Alright, and go ahead and pump. So usually you'll see when you guys do this that a bunch of air bubbles will come out. So basically you want to do it till just pure fluid comes out. Once pure fluid comes out, then you're gonna move on to the next brake caliper. I'm just doing it as much as I can so that I can get as much dot four fluid in. This is just my thing. You guys don't have to do that, right? All right, what's up guys? Back here with the EG, finished everything up. Didn't get to finish the video the same day because I had to gravity bleed all the brakes. Like I said, you don't have to do that. You just basically bleed all four sides until it doesn't have any air bubbles coming out and you should be fine. Make sure though, before you even move the car or anything, you pump the brakes and make sure that it's hard, okay? That it doesn't go all the way down to the floor, all right? So after that, you can go ahead and break in the brakes. I'll show you guys how to do that right now. All right, guys, the best way to do this would probably be going to the freeway. You usually drive about 60 miles per hour, stop a little bit, bring it back up, 60 miles per hour, stop a little bit. That's how you break it in. I got no horn, this guy's distracted. You don't want to be at a complete stop and just hold your brakes because that's how you overheat the brakes. Go ahead and we'll do a little pull right now. All
off like this, bring it back up. You want to stop again a little bit. Just here and there, you want to do it maybe like 10 times to break in your brake pads. Should be good after that. That's pretty much all you have to do. You're going to smell the brake pads initially, but it'll go away. That's totally normal. So as long as your brake pedal doesn't go all the way to the floor, you guys should be good. So when you guys are at a complete stop, like I said, don't hold on to your brakes. Just kind of let it go if you can. If you have to, obviously it's fine, but the reason is when you hold your brakes, it overheats the pad, so get a little uneven wear.
Do another little pull for you guys.
Here, my end.
Of course.